Hi folks, my name is Sean Janicek. I manage the Student Organic Farm for Clemson University. And we are doing research on organic no-till techniques that use a ryegrass cover crop through the winter time. And then we terminate that ryegrass cover crop and keep it in place as a thick mulch to suppress weeds, conserve moisture, prevent soil erosion. The benefits of organic no-till is huge for South Carolina farmers because basically allows them to conserve resources and save them an enormous amount of time in their farming operations. Organic no-till, you basically grow a cover crop and you use a roller crimper to lay that cover crop down flat, and the crimping action pinches the stems, crimps the stems, and if you do it at the right time, it causes the cover crop to die. And what that does is it leaves this thick mulch in place with that dead cover crop, protects the soil from erosion, prevents weeds from growing, and it conserves moisture. So it has a lot of benefits for farmers and for the soil and the environment. The problem with organic no-till is that the cover crop has to be mature enough in order for the crimping action to kill it and for it to work. So the cover crop needs to be at a very late stage where the seeds are, you know, starting to form inside those flowers. You want it to be in full flowering in order for it to work. So that really limits the time frame that we can use the technique to just a few weeks out of the year. And the mulch, another problem with it is that you only get weed suppression for about 5 weeks, and then that ryegrass starts breaking down and weeds will start coming through it. So a few years ago, I started adding leaves on top of the crimped cover crop, and that gave us season-long weed control by just adding a few inches of leaves on top of it. And then last year, what I realized is that if you add leaves on top of the crimped mulch, you can actually crimp much earlier. So last year, we crimped a few weeks earlier. So this year, we're actually running trials to see how early we can go and what's the minimum amount of mulch required to terminate the cover crop at an earlier date. So we're basically trialing and we're crimping the cover crops several months earlier than we normally would crimp, and then I'm applying different thicknesses of the shredded leaves on top of that crimped cover crop, and then I'm also applying different age classes of leaves. I'm applying older leaves, and then I'm applying fresher leaves on top of that to see what works better. And what we're realizing is you can basically crimp that cover crop several months earlier, which will allow us to do, if it works, when we plant our plants into it, it'll allow us to do the majority of our crops using organic no-till techniques and really expand the possibilities with this new technique.